Salutations, Jones Nation. Welcome back to the show. And today, we're going to tell you why Robinhood sucked.
It is amazing that you could take this big a budget, $100 million, supposedly, production.
And a couple of talented actors.
A lot of talented people. I mean, all over the place.
And then make it suck.
Suck.
That goes to show, script is very important. The story is very important. Action is not going to hold up the whole movie by itself. Neither are the actors who were portraying awful lines.
I think a lot of it was they tried to be too stylized. You need to have a little style and a good story and work it. Now, this story, if you're going to call it Robin Hood, is so well known that most people are like, heard it, been there. You know, so I think, and then they saw the over-stylized part, and I think people thought, Heavens to Murgatroyd is going to be like The Legend of King Arthur and the Sword, or King Arthur and the Legend of the Sword.
I mean, I had a friend who literally, like, leaned over me and was like, what time period is this? And I was like, it's medieval, but they're trying to be steampunk and stylish.
Yeah.
And if people are wondering what age period we got going on, then you didn't portray it right. I mean, if you're going to be stylized, make it obvious from the beginning.
I think that's one of the things that could have fixed it. If they had just said, this story is being told in a, you know, in some mythical universe or fantasy world, a different time period, and you're just watching the characters and the action, it might have worked at least a little better.
Okay, well, the action, I thought, well, for the most part, was entertaining, except for one CGI part. When you watch, ooh, it was bad. Like, I mean, it looked like at-home, do-it-yourself kind of bad. It was, ooh, it was
did
bad.
You like the arrows that when they hit the stone columns exploded it? Or the, what was it, Modern Warfare or Battlefield graphics?
Oh, well, no. You wish it was that good of graphics. No. But, no, like, in the beginning of the movie, Robin Hood, or, you know, Robin of Locksley goes off to war, and their squad is a bow and arrow squad, but if they switched to bow and arrows with, like, an M16 or something, it looked like they're in Iraq. They were wearing, you know, like, tan jackets with, like, bulletproof
all
vest
matching
things,
uniforms,
cargo pants, some kind of boots without a helmet, but they're carrying a bow and arrow, and they're checking their corners and whatnot, and it's like, what the heck? And it's, like, close-quarters arrow combat. It was weird. I mean, it was semi-entertaining, but they also had these automatic crossbow things, like, toon, 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 going shooting that fast.
But sometimes that same gun would shoot five, and it's like, hold it. If it's toon, 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 how all of a sudden it's five?
It's a really good crossbow. Start off with a shotgun shot, and then just machine gun it afterwards. I would not want to be in that time period.
And then, the way they thrust in Maid Marian's character.
Yeah.
They're trying.
Isn't she royalty or something in the actual.
Well, yeah, she wouldn't have been a commoner just yelling in the streets, kind of baloney.
She was just like a thief in the streets with some other dude in the streets that were trying to rally the people, and it's like, okay, no.
And then some of you talk about steampunk motif. There are scenes where it looks like they just bought their clothes at the Gap and walked on the set. I mean, it's just like, oh, come on. I mean, it's not, you know, it's, you're not supposed to be in modern times, but it's not stylized. It was just stupid costumes. And other scenes, they seem to change the script just because the director says, I got some more budget and I want people to be walking in front of fire. And so what can we do with the story? Can we just come up with something totally ludicrous so they'll be walking in front of fire? Hate that.
Yeah, very weird plot devices, weird story development and arcs. Even the two main characters, Robin and the Little John, like, I mean, the actors are good, but they did the best with what they got, and it wasn't good even then. And they were trying to go for a stylized, fast pace Robin, like shooting three arrows in a second, running through hallways and like fighting hand to hand, and then shooting off a couple guards. And I would prefer something more traditional and more realistic, but, you know, still really cool shots and stunts. It was too much. The action couldn't hold it up all the way. I mean, I was a little entertained, but it was not good.
I mean, I like, in theory, the story of Robin Hood. My dad used to read it to me when I was a little fella. And I saw the original Kevin Costner version, and even the Errol Flynn version, and even Russell Crowe's version, which I wasn't really thrilled about. But it's been done so many times. It's a story everyone knows. And trying to modernize it, I mean, I had hope that it would be like Knight's Tale, where they kind of modernized that and Heath Ledger knocked it out of the ballpark. But
Nope.
So,
not good at all. Which, you know, hey, if you haven't seen it yet, good on you. Wait till Redbox or Cable. But me personally, I think I'd pay $100 to see this in theater again because it was that good.
Actually, as I recall, when you were walking out with your buddies, you said, we should have gone to see Creed 2 again.
Yeah, I did. All my friends were like, wait, you want to see Creed 2 again? We should have saw Creed 2. I was like, yeah, I could have watched that again. That was way better.
If you go see it in theaters, because I don't know if they'll change it before the cable release, there is a scene early in the Loxley Manor where Jamie Foxx, who's supposed to be missing a hand, is wearing a blue glove on that hand, and they didn't edit it out. So there's a scene for a split second where you see him walking around with a blue glove, and it's like, you know, that's an IMDb caught it thing.
Yeah, but anyway, that is fine. So yeah, this is why this movie sucked, and this is why you should not go see it. You should go see Creed 2, and maybe Instant Family. I like that one. I thought it was cute. Maybe some other ones, but not.
Save your money and spend it wisely. Jones Nation helping you again.
You're welcome. We did you a service.
Yeah, peace.
And just for that, you should at least drop a like and at least subscribe and at least hit that bell notification, because come on, you want to be up to date. You want to get the reviews. You want to be notified when they drop. So do all that and let's have a discussion in the comments. What's happening? Did you see this movie? Do you agree? Do you not want to see it? Let us know.
Which Robin Hoods did you like?
Yeah.
Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Jones Boys Review. And leave a comment. This is for fun. This is a community. Let's talk movies.
Yeah, I am curious. Let's see. What Robin Hoods did you like? If you say Russell Crowe's, then I might have to disagree with you. But other than that, we can have a discussion about it. I think at this point, I might as well say the cartoon was my favorite.
Yeah, the cartoon version's right up there.
Cartoon gets it right.
Maybe Men in Tights was better than this, and that was the parody version.
It's slightly funnier, yeah. Oh, well.
So, anyway.
Hey, until the next one, guys. Adios, Nation.
Peace.